dear friends. I'm Gauri and doing research on the topic e-business models, opportunities and challenges for the MSME sector under the guidance of Professor Dr. Gabriel Saiban Tatil. So, moving on to my topic, there has been a very wide increase in the usage of mobile phones and computers over the years. And almost majority of the population are now techno-savvy, especially the youth. And this has leveraged the internet penetration rate in our country also. I hope majority of you would be very happy if you get everything on your fingertips. So e-business facilitates this thing. That is, a main example is ordering of food through Zomato or Swiggy, which we do daily or almost all days. And then another is conducting Google transaction, payment transactions online via Google Pay or Phone Pay and the like. So, when this technology is adopted by business enterprises, it becomes e-business, which is one focus area of my research. And another key area is MSME sector, which is the micro, small and medium enterprises. And this is one among the most promising sector of Indian economy after agriculture. And due to its importance, government is also offering various schemes and incentives for them. So, they can further be classified as manufacturing and service sector based on the nature of its operation. So, these are the two focus areas in my research. And the key research problem is to know whether the MSMEs which has adopted e-business could take advantage of the opportunities that it provides and also to identify the various challenges associated with e-business. These are the primary objectives. And there are various MSMEs which use the basic tools of e-business only, like email or social networking sites like Facebook, Instagram, etc. Whereas there are MSMEs which use the high-end tools also. So this variation might be due to various factors. And these are the secondary objectives in my study, that is to analyze the factors which influence e-business adoption and also the extent of adoption. And for my study, I collect primary data both from manufacturing as well as service sector enterprises, and a comparison is made between the two sectors based on the above mentioned objectives. This is depicted in my slide. So with this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you.